In this next lesson, let's look at the supporting AF model and the features we'll be using in this course. When you open PiSystem Explorer, it should be pointing to the Dryers AF model, which is the one we'll be using in this course. In the lower left-hand corner of the PiSystem Explorer window, you'll see different views listed. Let's start by selecting the Elements view. Here, we can look at all the elements that have been configured in our model. And in this case, there's only two of them, Dryer A and Dryer B. Go ahead and select Dryer A. And then select the tab named Attributes. This gives you a list of all the attributes configured for Dryer A. Each attribute maps to a Pi point, which could be a value coming from the plant or the results of an asset analytic calculation. Now select the Analysis tab at the top of the window. Here you'll see a list of asset analytics that have been configured for the Dryer template. There are quite a few of them. These are the analytics that we're going to recreate through the hands-on exercises in this course. Now let's take a look at the template. So go down and select the Library view in the lower left-hand corner of PiSystem Explorer. Under the Templates hierarchy at the top, expand the Element Templates branch. And here you'll find the Dryer template for this AF model. Select the tab called Analysis Templates, and you'll see the exact same list of asset analytics that you saw in the Dryer element. This is where we're going to be doing most of the work for the course. We'll be configuring new asset analytics here, and then they'll automatically get applied to the two Dryer elements for Dryer A and Dryer B. Let's take a look at each of these analytics. The first one's called Dryer Notification. This will be the analytic that has the notification rule in it that sends the email. Actually, it will be the one we do at the very end of the course. The Dryer Regeneration Cycle Time Forecast will be the analytic we'll use to make the prediction of the upcoming Dryer Regeneration Cycle Time. The third one, called Dryer Regeneration Events, will be an analytic we'll use to create some event frames. And then the next three, the Dryer State analytics, we're going to use those to calculate the state of each dryer based on the outlet temperature we talked about in the previous lesson. And then the final analytic, called Total Barrels Dried, will be a calculation that accumulates the total barrels fed through each of the dryers. One will be for calculating the accumulated total throughout its lifetime, and the other one will be for calculating the barrels through a specific period of time when it's in the drying mode. Then if you go up to the top and select the tab called Notification Rule Template, here's where we'll be configuring the format and the recipients of the email notification we're going to send to the operators, reminding them that it's time to regenerate one of the feed dryers. And with that, I think we're all set. We've gained some domain knowledge, so we know the process we'll be working with, and we've taken a good look at the AF model that supports all the work we're going to be doing in this course. So now it's time to get started with some data exploration and engineering.